Welcome back, how is it going? In this tutorial, I will show you how to create an UI web design with Glassmore Prism Effect in Inkscape. Let's begin. Create a background with the Tangle tool, you can click this icon, or the shortcut is R. Make sure you turn on this toggle snapping and this toggle snapping to the page border. For easier, when you drag in, it will automatically fit to the page. Like this. And change the color to this 20% gray for this temporary, because we're going to create the glass effect with the background in here. Next, duplicate the rectangle to create an inner rectangle in here. Duplicate the rectangle, press Ctrl D and hold Ctrl Shift while you're dragging. You see that the bounding box around here, and you can change the color to the 10% gray. Press F2 or you can click this icon, the edit mode, and drag this circular node. It will create an rounded rectangle effect. Next, the layouting with the guides. So we're going to drag to the left, place the guides in here, and the right side. And for the header one, place it on here. And for the title, drag from the top to create a line. For the bottom one, we're going to create a columns, so just drag from the left. This side is more wider. This for image later in here, so I'm just going to create this layout. Next, we're going to add the text element, press T. And type, change the font to, change the size to, and change the style to, let's change this OO to this color. So for the selected text, by going to this edit objects, or the shortcut is shift control F. If you want to change the selected text color, you cannot use the Drupal tool, so we're going to input this color code to here. Let's type. And for the menu, so I'm just going to duplicate this, press Ctrl D, move it to here, and let's change the size to, duplicate again, press Ctrl D. A tip for you to align it precisely, so just select all of this, and choose this align and distribute objects, or shortcut is Shift Ctrl A. And click this distribute centers, so it will align precisely between the objects, alright? And let's give some rectangle highlight to the order now. So with the rectangle tool, click this icon and place it on here, and press F2 to enter the edit mode. Hold the circle node to create a rounded rectangle. Press F1 or you can click this icon and send it to the lower back. Change the text color to white. You can hide these guides in view and uncheck this guide, or the shortcut by pressing shift and the vertical bar. Next, for heading or the title, you can turn on these guides, or the with the shortcut this shift and vertical bar. Change the text to, change the size to, place it on here. Reduce this space by selecting all these text and click this minus. A subheading in here, so I'm just going to duplicate this, press Ctrl D. Place it on here and change the text to, change the text color to 70% gray. I forgot to change this black color to this black dove color, so to do that, click the text and go to edit, select same and choose the fill color. So it will select the same color all of in this canvas, and press T to activate Drupal tool and click this. Let's change this color to this. Right, for the content with the image, turn on the guides by pressing shift and this vertical bar. With the rectangle tool, click this icon and draw some rectangle, and let's change the color to the 50% gray. Make it rounded by pressing F2. Straight down. import the image in file, import, just this, just click OK. You can scale it down proportionally by holding Ctrl Shift. Okay, place it in the middle of the rectangle and select these two by shift click. Turn down a little and type the menu name. Turn the font to, turn the type to, right, place it on here. And for the description, press Ctrl D, type again, change the color to the 60% gray, and add some divider in here with the rectangle tool. Remove the rounded, just make it up, and the pricing, and add icon. So I'm just going to duplicate, press Ctrl D, and change it to plus, increase the size to, okay, place it on here, add a rectangle, rectangle tool, press F2, and just make it slightly rounded, change the color to this color. Move it to the lower back, click this icon, and change color to white. Line it in the middle, so click the plus and the rectangle. Then go to align and distribute objects. Make sure you choose the last selected, because our last selected is the rectangle. So click this icon and this. And add more menu, so I'm just going to duplicate this. Press Ctrl D. And duplicate this, press Ctrl D, and place it on here, and scale it up by holding Ctrl Shift. Add a drop shadow by clicking the image, and go to Filters, Shadow and Glow, choose the drop shadows. Active Display Preview, and adjust the shadow where you want. Next, for the glass morphism effect, let's import the background image in VAL, import, and just this, hit OK, and scale it up by holding Ctrl Shift, and send it to the lower back. Because I'm going to create a clipping mask, this rectangle to this background image, alright? Before I'm going to clip it, duplicate again for this inner rectangle, so press Ctrl D, and send it to the lower back. The first one, the rectangle, and this, hold Shift, then click, right click, just set clip. Right, now you see that it's applied on the background. And for the other one, press Ctrl D for the inner rectangle. This is for the glass morphism later, so, and send it to the lower back for a moment. And the inner rectangle, and this, not this, right? Right click, just set clip. And send this background to the lower back because it's in the front now. And this, send it to the lower back because we want to bring the glass effect in the front. Now we're going to create a blur effect. So click the background. And on this fill and stroke menu, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl F. Make sure you turn on the blur in here, not in the layer. Because if you increase the blur on this layer, it will blur all of the things on this canvas. Make sure you blur on this fill and stroke menu. Click the object and increase the blur. Alright. And with gradient tool, we will create a glass effect. Click this icon, or the shortcut is G. And just drag it on this node and this node. Change the color by double click. And change it to white color. And this, you can double click. Change it to this color. on this bottom right node, just double click. On the left corner, right click, choose remove wheel. So it will create a semi-transparent effect. You can adjust it. Now select the back object by Control Alt click or press Alt click and increase the blur. And on the front, click and press F2 if you want to edit the gradient again and adjust it. And do the same for this foot menu. I want to change the roasted chicken to this color. Turn the text to white and this invert it. This is the white and this is the yellow one. And add the stroke in stroke style. Change it to pixel. Make it by 10. In the stroke pane, click this flat color. Turn on the alpha to see. And now we are going to create the gradient to the stroke. Click the rectangle and go to the stroke pane. Choose the radial gradient. Right, you can place and rotate. Just try it. Let's see, press F1. Let's create a noise fill by clicking the rectangle and go to filter, overlay, and choose the noise fill. And you can try to increase the horizontal and vertical to bring the dots and dilatation, bright and dark in here. On noise color, the lightness in 75, just hit apply and close. So this is the before and this is the after. And the last thing for the particles, by going to file, import, and click this leaves. Hit open. I want to take these leaves and this, just duplicate it, press Ctrl D and place it on here. With Bezier tool, press B and select these leaves. Alright, press F1. Make sure you select the Bezier and hold Shift, then click the leaves and right click, just set clip. That's how you select the image objects in Inkscape, by using the clipping mask. And I'm going to give a blur by going to filter, blurs, and click the blur. This is a preview and you can play with this setting. Light and close. And for another one. And for the last one, we're going to file, import. You can press H on the keyboard to flip it horizontally and rotate it by click again until you see this rotate icon. Place it on here. That's how you can create the glass morphism effect in Inkscape by blurring the inner objects and the outside, then bring the gradient in the front. Keep practicing. I'm ZK from ZK Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.